Mass transfer trades are another alternative of mass transfer processes and columns. The basic working principle of these trades is presented as follows. Similar to a column with random packing, the liquid is fed from the top of the column while the gas line is fed from the bottom of the column and rises to the top in a countercurrent flow. The liquid flows over the tray horizontally, its source being the downcomer plate. It flows across the active area to the downcomer on the opposite end of the tray. The liquid accumulates by means of the weir positioned just before the downcomer. The gas passes through the trays via the valve openings. There are different types of valve openings depending on various specific process conditions. Sieve trays are the simplest and hence cheapest type of mass transfer trays, as they are simply punched holes for passage of the gas. This tray type has a limited load range as the liquid flows through the openings at light gas load operation. Valve trays compensate for this weak point by using openings with a dynamically variable valve opening, which is related to the gas flow rate. A further improvement of the load range can be achieved by bubble cap trays for metals and tunnel trays for plastics. The following movie illustrates the process inside a column with tunnel trays. The column itself is designed with an internal diameter of 2190 mm and a tray spacing of 500 mm. The caps of the trays are arranged at right angles to the flow direction of the liquid. The caps themselves are slotted at a bottom for better gas flow, which increases performance. The 27 mm tall slots are arranged at a diagonal angle. The height of the effluent weir is 60 mm. This setup is designed for a process condition with a maximum F factor of 0.9 square root of Pascal and a liquid flow rate less than 100 liters per hour. In the beginning, the gas load is adjusted to 3,500 cubic meters per hour, corresponding to an F factor of 0.29 square root of Pascal, while the liquid load is fixed at 60 liters per hour throughout the test. Under these conditions, the slots are opened by the upforce of the gas to about a third of their maximum possible opening. Notice the way the valve positions vary drastically due to the small pressure differences of the rising gas stream. Now, the gas load is raised to the designed operating point of 8,100 cubic meters per hour, corresponding to an F factor of 0.65 square root of Pascal. The slots of the caps are now occupied approximately two-thirds of the way by the gas. The average total height of the gas-liquid mixture is about 160 mm. Any entrainment of the greater droplets cannot be observed. The system shows an optimum behavior as the leakage rate of the active area is low, the mixing of the gas and the liquid is intensive, and the entrainment is low. Now the gas load is raised furthermore to 11,000 cubic meters per hour and respectively an F factor of 0.89 square root of Pascal. The slots are almost completely free of liquid, and the height of the gas-liquid mixtures increases to 60 to 70 mm as an average. Greater droplets are being entrained up to 300 to 350 mm, while finer droplets are reaching the upper tray plate. The system is working at the limit of entrainment. Finally, a flow analysis test is done by adding a coloring agent to the liquid. The agent is applied to the liquid at the liquid inlet under the process conditions as before, a gas load of 11,000 cubic meters per hour and a liquid load of 60 liters per hour. It is evident that the period of time beginning from the input of coloring agent up to the complete distribution over the entire active area takes about 5 minutes. This correlates to the time taken for mass of the transfer process. Furthermore, it is visible that the distribution of color is rather homogeneous. An advantage of having the slots angled and having the angles alternate from one tunnel to the next is that the gas is forced to continuously reverse direction, creating a better chance for mass transfer to occur, further increasing the performance of the trays.